Hello, I'm Blaze. We will learn about oxygen cycle. Educational update is now available to all viewers. The oxygen cycle is the biogeochemical transitions of oxygen atoms between different oxidation states in ions, oxides, and molecules through redox reactions within and between the spheres or reservoirs of the planet Earth. The Earth's atmosphere, hydrosphere, and biosphere together hold less than 0.05% of the Earth's total mass of oxygen. Its reservoirs are atmosphere, biosphere, hydrosphere, and lithosphere. The topic which Silver the Hedgehog taught, called atmospheric layers on Earth. Let's meet him. Silver? Did you know about atmospheric layers?
Yes, Blaze.
We are ready to go through details.
Okay.
First, let's start with atmosphere. It consists of 21% volume of oxygen. Now you go on to the next one.
Biosphere?
Yeah.
It's 22% oxygen by volume. Hydrosphere, 33% of oxygen volume. And lithosphere, 47% of its oxygen volume. So, which one is the highest oxygen volume?
Well, Silver, you said that its lithosphere is 47% volume.
Yes.
Many types of reservoirs you see like biomass, water, ozone, and others.
Yeah. Also, like many rocks and salts, such as magnesium oxide, calcium oxide, aluminium oxide, and others.
But we see in this diagram, there are four main reservoirs like terrestrial, marine, lithosphere and atmosphere. Its unit can be given in trillion moles per year.
Means it's 10 to the 12th power.
Yeah, in marine biosphere, as you wish.
Yeah?
The water releases 4,000 trillion moles per year as per photosynthesis. And it takes 4,000 trillion moles back into the water by respiration. Whereas terrestrial biosphere releases 5,000 trillion moles per year for photosynthesis and it takes back with respiration. Anything can be done like other reservoirs like lithosphere. It can oxidize roughly 20 trillion moles per year, and it's outgassing 0.3 trillion moles per year. This is what the oxygen cycle works.
Thank you very much for the detail.
Like, comment, and subscribe now.